Maria Stefan. I'm not an archaeologist. My background is computer science and learning technologies. But I'm working for 5 years with Professor Gheorghiu from the National University of Arts in Bucharest. He's an architect and an archaeologist. For this session, we will present our research in advanced visual education and archaeology using OpenSim, the experience of the time-lapse project. Currently, under the label Virtual Worlds, one finds a category of real-time 3D open platforms with social and communication capabilities which improve the learning process. Depending on the learning objectives, teachers can employ an advanced graphical environment dedicated to individual study of details or a simplified system available online which can be employed by a group of participants as well as individually. The most popular platforms for developing online and real-time 3D virtual worlds are Second Life and OpenSimulator. Unity 3D as a game engine is employed for games and hyper-realistic 3D reconstructions, and it is also a recent option for the development of virtual worlds. Apart from other studies, the present technological and pedagogical research methods evaluates both environments, OpenSim and Unity 3D, not separately, but in connection one with another, with the objective of developing a more complex learning environment focused on visual-based learning in order to approach concepts which are difficult to be represented, such as architectural spaces. The method is presented by us as an advanced immersion from simple to complex, from a 3D immersive experience in an OpenSim virtual world to a graphical rich reconstruction using Unity 3D. The learning process is represented by the spatial experience of the traditional or ancient architectural context. The motivation of the utilization of digital reconstructions is justified by the difficulty to access historical sites and the rarity of complete ancient architectural structures. By visiting them in a 3D environment, one can have a phenomenological experience with a high degree of cognitive character, which involves the visual memory of the visitor. It is well known that vision is the most important cognitive channel, sense, and hence this is the reason for the method's attempt to offer in both environments the visual information capable to support learning through a progression from simple forms to complex visual representation. The time-lapse project is concerned with important research work to promote learning in mixed learning environments, in our case with augmented virtuality. The overall purpose was to improve the educational process by creating authentic architectural and archaeological contexts. The OpenSim virtual learning environment was meant to allow students from different remote locations to access and better explore the learning resources within the time-lapse project. The current research hypothesis was that combining the two environments under the form of a new learning instrument will provide a more complex and complete learning environment which highlights the students' knowledge gaps and helps teachers to better focus on specific topics, resulting in an enhancement of the learning process. The student can thus take advantage of the benefits provided by each environment. Here we are, OpenSim. This is an OpenSim simulator, and this is the Unity 3D with the same architectural space. In OpenSim, our virtual world is composed of 3D buildings and objects representing a Roman rustic villa, a workshop, a small part of it. While the Unity 3D has been adopted as a virtual reality visualization and learning tool due to its graphical performances in real time and multi-platforms capabilities. Both environments, OpenSim and Unity3D, were developed as online augmented virtuality environments, which means that specific graphical objects were augmented with video-based learning resources. The proposed research method represents a comparative analysis of spatial experience in the two different 3D immersive environments employed together consecutively. Both environments attempt to create virtual reality environments, but with different rules and characteristics. OpenSim, as a free and open variant of Second Life metaverse and social platform, supports the implementation of real-time VR systems in which the user is part of it. Its disadvantage is the requirement to drastically simplify the 3D models by reducing the number of polygons and textures, for example, by using UV maps. On the other hand, Unity3D is a graphic container optimized for performant 3D renderings and allows hyper-realistic simulation. Its disadvantage is that in order to accommodate a larger number of simultaneous visitors, a network infrastructure and the programmatic implementation of advanced capabilities are necessary. In the open sim-based 3D virtual online environment, the students are having a first immersive experience and a direct relation with a virtual environment consisting in 3D architectural reconstructions and multimedia learning resources and become better acquainted with a historical context. In Unity3D, students can analyze detailed reconstructions of architectural objects and archaeological contexts. The proposed method is based on the transfer of experience between the two analogical virtual learning tools. Here, analogy is perceived as a connection between similar patterns from the two different visual worlds with different degree of cognition. Thus, a 3D reconstructions of ancient contexts in Unity3D are similar to those in OpenSim, which is based on simplified forms due to technical reasons. Both environments employ video insertion within the virtual reconstructions by means of 3D media primitive or hotspots. Primitive is in OpenSim, and here is a hotspot which opens a window with a visual with a video resources. Thus producing the mixed reality. Furthermore, to facilitate the transfer from OpenSim to the Timemaps web page in which the Unity3D reconstructed context is hosted, OpenSim's capability to integrate web information is used. In fact, here we have an internal browser. So the proposed method is thus concerned with the progressive utilization of the 3D immersive learning environment for enhanced understanding and visual memorization. The pedagogical experiment comprised three stages. In stage one, the experiment started with an open scene-based simulator, a simplified social VR, in which several users, the teacher and the students, immerse themselves within the multi-user online space. In stage two, experiment, each user immersed himself as a single user in Unity3 virtual application, which is a hyper-realistic virtual reality of the architectural context. Here we have the same scene and the hotspots. In stage three, it was useful for the teachers to verify the degrees of memorization at the student, which was transferred between the two 3D environments. In this stage, a pedagogical study took place consisting in the verification by the teacher of the visual memory of the student by requesting some data from the context seen in Unity 3D after re-immersing him in OpenSim and taking a time period after a week, months, or 2-3 months. This transfer from one medium to another compels the person experiencing this shift first to understand the context in which he, she came, to position himself within it, and to network with other visitors, in the case of OpenSim. This situation of being in the virtual world is amplified by the process of socialization between avatars, together with the perception of their own body, therefore a paradoxical feeling of immersion and consequently of reality, which allows an expanded experience of the built space as well as some additional visual and phenomenological experiences. Switching from an individual phenomenological experience spent in a hyper-realistic context to one in a minimalist context, but with strong social involvement, followed after a certain time by a reverse experience back from Unity to OpenSim, compels a person to a context mental exercise that improves the iconic memory and as well the embodied cognition. Concluding this experience, the OpenSim immersive environment allows the development of the imagination and spatial analysis, but limits the quality of the graphical content of the reconstruction. For this reason, an experimental method of progressive immersion was applied in order to overcome this limitation and to improve the cognitive process and the visual memory. Initially, the student has experimented an immersion in the simplified context in which the attention was focused on the general forms of the object, not being disturbed by details, and where he, she can interact with other persons. In the second stage, in the Unity 3D VR application, the student can study the context detail in an alternative state of immersion. We consider that the advanced learning in OpenSim is improved by the reverse process, which is a transition from complex to simpler forms, from experience of reconstruction with many details to simplified models. We made some evaluation of this method, which showed that the learning outcomes were better than would be obtained by isolated utilization of each environment. This is our experiment made with students, but also with children from secondary school. Thank you for your attention. I can make a short demonstration during the coffee break, provided that I can enable the internet.
Yeah,
because I experienced some difficulties.
Yes. It should be on.